All my life I've done only this one mistake. All my life I've done only this one mistake. The dust was on my face, I kept wiping the mirror. All my life I've done only this one mistake. I kept wiping the mirror, whereas the dust was lying on my face. By the time you get that the dust is lying on your face, where are you? Where are you? I see you, Yashoda Hospital, Mercy Hospital, Mary Hospital, Rama Hospital, Krishna Hospital. Every lane has one hospital nowadays. If you see, it's shocking. Every hospital is overflowing, by the way. You have to be in a waiting queue. It's a situation where the bodies have to be outside. There's no place like that. Because we are so busy. What are we busy with? We are so busy running away from the source. Thinking there is somewhere else, the source somewhere else is what my life is happening somewhere else. There my life is. There. Where? Nowhere. By the time you get to that there, which you will never get to, you're gone. You're already on your deathbed. And that time probably some great, you know, Buddhahood will happen on you. And you will say, oh God, now I got, you know, this I should have done like when? 200 years back. Now I want to do it. But what's happening around me now? I cannot move a single nerve or limb in my body. And what's happening if I want help? What kind of help can you see? You're seeing someone waiting for you. Maybe your son, maybe your daughter, daughter-in-law, grandchildren, I don't know. Oh, today is Friday, please drive fast because I don't need to apply a leave. Tomorrow is a holiday, day after is a holiday, two leaves saved. How many days? Yeah, 10 days. No, in 10 days, two leaves gone, 8 days is left, one compensatory off I have. Bah, you have to die today. Today is the perfect day for you to die. I will save 3 leaves. Don't you dare die on a Monday. Oh God, that's the last thing you should be doing. Monday you die, two more leaves I have to waste on you. People are waiting for you to die on a weekend so that they can save their annual holiday. That's when you know nothing can be done. Nothing can be done. Human life is the most paradoxical life. I'm so shocked at human beings. It is shocking and stunning. And I include myself in this because I was also there in that race. Thank God, literally God, Swamiji, for really giving me the life that I have today. Really. Otherwise, it is so shocking. We are so blind. Oh God, I don't know if there's anything beyond blindness. We are that. Such ignorance, such a deep slumber. And we are running, we are waging wars, we are fighting with people, we are killing people with property, poisoning, this, that, for what? Beautifully what Shakespeare says, all life is a song sung with full fist and fury by an idiot and a fool to signify what? Nothing. What happens to all of this? It all boils down to just that one patch of ground that is there, that's all. 6 feet. Either they dig you or they bury you. Whatever they do to you, you're there. Or they throw you to animals, which many people do when you're dead. Even then, the last remains have to go back to the earth. There's nothing. And for that nothing, you give up everything. And you keep on fighting and dying and dying and dying. And you're long before dead, before you're actually dead. See any story of the humanity, this is what you will see. Unless it's the story of realized people and people who follow realized people. You see any story, tell me which is different from this. Even the most famous to the most unfortunate beggars on the street, all are in the same level. All of them, there is no difference. Whether you own a Merc or whether you own a rickshaw on the street, doesn't matter. Doesn't matter till you do not get into the space which is the holistic completion that you innately are born with. If you cannot restore that back to yourself, whatever you're doing now, whatever you've done till now, whatever you will be doing is completely zero, useless. Completely useless, and you will die a pauper. I don't mean to depress any one of us with this. I'm only meaning to make you all get that is why it is so much important to get that completion is really, life begins with completion, what Swamiji always, always says. How many of you are getting what I'm sharing? Raise your hand. So what begins like this, where bit by bit by bit, I get that there is a dent, there is a dent, there is a dent, there is a dent. I'm creating a dent from inside. by the various interpretations and cognitions I make. At one place I would have said, oh, I'm so scared, my life is going away, I am dying, or I am a failure, I am incapable, I am not strong enough, I am weak, or he is bad, she is bad, he is cruel, they are not so nice, they are out there to get me, he is a brutal animal who's there to eat me, whatever. Wherever you've had incomplete cognitions, you had cognition pushing you into further incompletions in your life, be very clear, you are leaking all over the place. No matter how much you will do outside, no matter how successful you are, I can challenge you. You will never experience fulfillment. And you will still have the suffering, which unfortunately success cannot remove suffering. Success can bring success, but cannot remove suffering. Suffering can be only taken away. Suffering doesn't even exist, by the way. When you bring forth fulfillment, suffering disappears. Just like how darkness has a negative existence. What do I mean by negative existence? It is not something which you can catch and remove. No, like this pen. It has a solid shape. If I have to remove this, I can just throw it out of the window, correct? But if it is dark in this room, can I throw dark out of the window? Can I get a bag, pack up the darkness and throw it out of the window? How can I throw out darkness? By switching on the light. Suffering is also like that. It does not exist, but it impacts you. The only way you can switch it off, move it away, is by switching on the light, bringing in the light of cognition, of completion into yourself. Are you guys getting this? So the next step of completion that we are speaking about includes, let me again say, it doesn't exclude you, begins with you, where you will always first do the Svapurnatva Kriya. The Svapurnatva, your completion with the self, will be the first step always. And it will extend to other people as well now. Why? Because when I say the holes, when I created these holes, what did I do? I have posted one incomplete me outside of me somewhere. Are we getting this? We worked with Radhika, when she got that situation with that hospital that day, a part of her was literally amputated and posted in that hospital. It's sitting there. Now she's incomplete with that aspect of her life. If you take your own life, when you probably first time fought with your brother or sister or mother, a part of you which had a hole got projected, posted there into that mother, brother, sister. And that you is still sitting inside them somewhere as an incomplete cognition. How many of you are getting this? So every time there is something that's coming incomplete for me, inside me it gets created and gets posted. A part of it is put out there in life. When I say in life, I mean all in different forms, in your mother, in your father, in various other things that is there in your life. Are you getting this? So what is the solution to this? Doing the Purnatva Kriya. First, it begins with Svapurnatva Kriya. What is Svapurnatva Kriya? Sva means self. Purnatva means completion. Self-completion process, all of us know, correct? We've done this, no? In the program, sitting with the mirror, bringing up the situations inside the mirror, you know, the past situations which left you incomplete, and then doing what? Reliving it, and at a point where you know the cognition is hitting you, going and healing and completing with that little self that you were inside the mirror. That's pretty clear in our understanding. We have to practice it, to get that space. Along with Svapurnatva, from now onwards, you will also extend doing what we call as the Purnatva Kriya, which is the Kriya for completion. Are we getting this? So, as I was talking, as I was listening to this conversation, first time I heard it, and as I got that how we make up our own stories about different things in our life. You know, first time when somebody gives you something, shouts at you or slaps you or says something, you know, or looks away from you, when you first time get, oh, they don't love me, was the time where you just divided yourself in that moment into two parts. One part you put there, which is incomplete, one part which is here. And both parts never have met again into a complete union again. Are we getting this? And that incompletion is impacting whom? Me. Isn't it? It is like I am an incomplete circuit, so I am impacted because of that. So what we got to do with the Purnatva Kriya is go back to each place where we may have deposited the different, we have, it's like, you know, fine pieces you have chopped yourself. Tuck, 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 tuck. It's shredded. Each piece is sitting somewhere. and one chunk you hold inside you. Now that piece is incomplete, you are also incomplete, both, at both levels. So first you have to, inside you itself, lot of pieces are there which are like cut, 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 different, 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 different. Through Swapurnatva, you are kind of bringing them into one unit inside. Then with Purnatva, you will slowly start restoring back that incomplete use sitting out there and bringing them back home, making one unit again. When that is done, then we'll see what will happen. That's what is the end result of this process. Are we getting what I'm saying? So far, are you following what I'm saying? So for this, what do you need to do? You need to look at your my world and the world situations of your life. Talk to people and share with them how your my world actually gave you who they are for you.